Hatice Sultan, known to us, was the younger sister of Sultan Suleiman the Magnificent. The princess was younger than her brother, the future Sultan, by about 2 years. Hatice Sultan was born in 1496 in Edirne. She was named after the first wife of the Prophet Muhammad. From her birth, Princess Hatice Sultan lived surrounded by love and care. She grew up in luxury and was honored like an Ottoman princess. Since Hatice was first a granddaughter, then a daughter, and then a sister of the Sultan, she was provided with respect and worship. Let's talk about whether there was love between Ibrahim Pasha and Hatice Sultan, and who was her husband really. Indeed, there is a version that Hatice Sultan was the wife of the Grand Vizier Ibrahim Pasha. Rumor has it that the Sultan married his sister to Ibrahim in order to bring him even closer to him and strengthen the position of the Grand Vizier as a son-in-law. And not at all because of the sudden flash of great love between the bride and groom, as shown in the TV series The Magnificent Century. According to this version, Hatice and Ibrahim got married in 1524, playing a magnificent wedding that lasted 15 days. This significantly affected the treasury, because a lot of money was spent on the celebration. Dissatisfied with this, the Janissaries decided to stage a riot. Sultan Suleiman presented the newlyweds with a large luxurious palace in Istanbul. This palace has survived to our times, now it is the Museum of Islamic Art. In fact, the story says that Ibrahim Pasha had a rather lavish wedding. But not a single source confirms that Hatice was his wife. Although some still indicate that it could be the Sultan's sister, her name is not mentioned. Rumors about love and marriage between Hatice and Ibrahim were born thanks to the historian Ismail Haki Yuzuncharshil. It was he who, in his publication, reported that Ibrahim's wife was Hatice. But later the author himself hastened to refute this version. So who did Hatice Sultan marry then, if not Ibrahim? Remember how in the series they said that Hatice was left a widow early, having married very young? There is a version that in 1509, at the age of 13, Hatice Sultan was married to Iskander Pasha. However, this marriage did not last long, as the husband of the lady died of a heart attack in his bed. Iskander Pasha died in 1515. Based on this, it turns out that this marriage lasted 6 years. And then the widowed Hatice returned to her mother and lived with her in Manisa. When Suleiman became Sultan, she moved with Valide Hafsa Sultan to Topkapi Palace. But there is one Iskander, and in one of the sources the author reports that Hatice's real husband was not Iskander Pasha, but Iskander Chernoevich. He was from Montenegro and belonged to the noble family of Chernoevich. His real name was Alexander. But in Turkey, he received a new name Iskander, consonant with the name Alexander. Iskander Chernoevich was the governor of Montenegro. And he had the honor of becoming the husband of Hatice Sultan. By the way, as for Hatice, this was his second marriage. Most likely, by that time he was a widow and therefore he was able to safely marry the sister of the Sultan. In this marriage, Hatice Sultan gave birth to 5 children. Osman Shah Bey, Ali Bey, Nefiz Khatun, Suleiman Bey, Mehmet Shah Bey. Probably, in 1509, Hatice married Iskander Chernoevich, and not Iskander Pasha. This can be judged by the date of birth of children. Osman Shah Bey was born in 1510. Ali Bey's second son was born in 1511. Nefiz Hatun was born in 1512. After her, Suleiman Bey was born in 1514. And finally, Mehmet Shah Bey was born in 1515. And the children attributed to Hatice are actually the children of the son of Ibrahim and 2 daughters of Hatice. After the death of her husband in 1530, Hatice Sultan returned to Istanbul and continued to live there until the end of his life. She never married again. In the series, we were shown a very touching, romantic and at the same time sad love story of Hatice and Ibrahim. In the film, their paths almost parted. But all the same, Suleiman connected the lovers by marriage. But even after that, their life was not easy. First, Hatice has a miscarriage during a riot. Then she tragically loses her first 2 children. And gives birth to twins, a son and a daughter. The year is 1536 in the series. By this time, Ibrahim Pasha was not only the Grand Vizier, Sir Asker, but also the closest friend of the Sultan. They dined together at the same table, went hunting, shared their leisure time, discussed and made grandiose plans. Suleiman swore to Ibrahim to protect him from everyone, even from himself. But the government spoiled Ibrahim. It got to the point that the Grand Vizier began to call himself a Pasha. This was immediately reported to the Sultan. This was the beginning of the end. Ibrahim lost the confidence of the ruler and was executed on his orders. There is a version that his little son was executed along with him. Hatice was left alone with the children. She could not come to terms with the death of Ibrahim and grieved for a long time. Shortly after the death of her husband, Hatice was never able to recover from the tragedy. She kidnaps Harem, where the captive no one knows except Hatice. But she takes this secret with her to the grave, poisoning herself with poison in front of the ruler. This is how Princess Hatice dies in the TV series Magnificent Century. In fact, no one knows what exactly Hatice Sultan died from. The princess was buried next to her mother Aish Hafsa Sultan, in the mausoleum of Shahzada near the mosque of Sultan Selim Yavuz. In various Turkish sources, one can find the probable dates of the death of Hatice Sultan. 1538, or simply written after 1538. So they write because the last burial in the mausoleum took place in 1538. And it was Hafiz Sultan, another sister of Suleiman and Hatice. There is another version according to which Hatice Sultan died in 1582. It turns out that she was able to live up to about 86 years. So it turns out that in the series they lied a lot. In life, Hatice really married a rather adult man with a very young girl. But their marriage lasted a long time and 5 children were born in it, who successfully survived infancy and managed to live their lives. And Hatice herself did not die of grief after the loss of her husband, but probably lived a decently long life. I thank you for watching. Give this video a like. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And continue to stay with me so as not to miss new interesting stories about the Ottoman Empire. See you soon.